Wow, and meteorologist Devon Lucie is here with more. And Devon, explain what the threat in the area looks like right now at this moment.
Well, the threat's over and done. They had some flood watches that were up. Those have all been either canceled early or they've been let up, canceled early since 11 o'clock our times when those storms went to. Let's look at the radar imagery over the past 24 hours. This actually started very late last night in North Carolina, early morning hours. You can start to sign flood advisories that started around Raleigh were quickly upgraded to flash flood warnings. When you start to see those areas outlined, if it would be in light blue, those are flash flood emergencies, which you didn't find here were any of those flash flood emergencies. Just flash flood warnings just goes to show that a flash flood warning can still be just as dangerous in situations such as flooding, that it can happen in just an instant, unfortunately, as we've already seen this season. Let's see our Doppler radar back at home and go to just the last 15 minutes. And you're going to find out that Doppler radar is only going to show that we've got a couple of showers that are out of the area. WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler radar. You can see close to Baton Rouge, east of us, and then out of Outer Plaquemines in St. Bernard Parish. That's the only rain we have here tonight. So we'll get right into our forecast, where we begin with the tropics. We've started to really ramp things up, but this is typical. We get into August, as we know, and things are really heating up. So this tropical storm Dexter, no worries here. 50-mile-per-hour winds, and you look at the latest forecast here right at 10 o'clock tonight. It's forecast to just be up to Category 1 hurricane. However, it's not going to be a tropical system tomorrow. It's going to be just getting its energy from warm air, cold air interactions, not from the heat of the ocean. The water temperature is so cool. Low chance of development off the east coast of the U.S. and a medium chance of development, which is now an invest, deemed 96L. We'll begin with the area of low chance of development, which was up to a moderate chance the last few days. Quite the storms that did form today, but now that we've set the sun for the night, those storms really fading fast. And you look at the forecast data, and I'm just not impressed with this at all. This forecast out of Europe, but is a little higher resolution, does show that it could be quite the system wrapping up, but not a whole lot of storm activity as we go to the middle of next week. But really, this thing moves northeast, so there's no worries and concerns for Louisiana. Back to the moderate risk for possible development or tropical formation. This is a storm system that'll be worth watching for a while. Large cluster of storms. The tropical wave centered more in this vicinity. And these are forecast tracks from our computer forecast that dedicated to more tropical systems and hurricanes. Does show a general consensus to move and start to bend a little farther north as it's moving west to Bermuda. This is the forecast here in the United States, an ensemble. Talk about these all the time. We take one forecast, we make a few changes, we run it about 30 times in the U.S. These are the centerline tracks, the mean, the median, those green lines, and that takes it farther away from leaving Louisiana. Few concerns here. The forecast data high resolution will show it's this high pressure, not the Bermuda high, that really takes hold. We'll grab that system and then pull it northward. So again, a couple of systems of possibilities and Dexter that's out, but nothing is moving our way. But the next storm that does develop, it'll be named Aaron. No hurricanes yet on the season. However, according to Dr. Phil Klotzbach, Colorado State University, the final update to his forecast today, same as July, 16 named storms, 8 hurricanes, 3 being major, compared to our forecast at WDSU, right in line with the same numbers and pretty close to averages for the time of the year. Locally, temperatures 70s, 80s, which is what we have this time of the year. Dew points way up at 70s. Hey, how about back to the bus stop tomorrow for some kids? Thursday morning, 78 degrees around the New Orleans area. Temperatures mainly in the 70s elsewhere. 40% chance of widely scattered storms. Heat of the day time, 11 a.m., noon, 1 to 2. Frequent lightning, locally heavy rain, gusty winds possible. As for top temperatures, we're working right at the average for the time of the year. Of course, the peak heat index could top out to 105 before the storms really get going. Into Friday, still have a 40% chance widely scattered storms. That latest forecast that's new tonight didn't show a whole lot. Got us anywhere from 89 to 92, right at those typical highs for the time of the year. Get into the weekend, and the same forecast, persistence. And we go to next week, Monday, Tuesday, little surge of tropical humidity, not connected with a tropical system. The temperature's up a couple notches, but we'll have more storm coverage, the feeling is by then.